Joining us this evening on debate number two, we'll introduce the ladies first. Nirmala Sitharaman, national spokesperson of the BJP. Good evening. Sabha Nakhui, political editor, Outlook. Good evening to you two. And also, good evening to C.R. Keshwan, spokesperson, Congress, and Sudhindra Bhadauria, leader, BSV. But the first question goes to Gaurav Bhatia, national president, legal wing of the Samajwadi Party. Gaurav Bhatia, Sabha ki kathni karne mein bahut fark hai, and actions speak louder than words. You are worried about the BJP onslaught in Uttar Pradesh, isn't it?
The only thing that the Samajwadi Party is worried about is that the BJP would try again to incite communal feelings. They'll again try the politics of communalism the way they did in Muzaffarnagar riots by orchestrating those riots, by sending Mr. Amit Shah to Ayodhya when he started this campaign. And now
Who's trying to polarize right now?
That's the point, isn't it, Gaurav? By fielding Mulayam Singh from Azamgarh, is the Samajwadi Party also not relying on polarizing votes? Is the Samajwadi Party also not looking to polarize votes by fielding Mulayam Singh from Azamgarh?
Let me make my point. I request you, and you will get your turn as well. The point that I'm trying to make is Muzaffarnagar riots happened because of the BJP. The MLAs who were the accused in those riots were felicitated by the BJP. Amit Shah goes to Ayodhya and says that Ram Temple would be built here when the matter is pending before the Supreme Court. Mr. Narendra Modi calls himself the symbol of development, but he does not choose any constituency which is deprived of development. He goes for Banaras. Why? Because they want to send a message. There is this Hindutva agenda that they have, but it's a hidden agenda, and they want to talk about
okay,
development.
Okay, who's responsible for now, the 246 incidents across Uttar Pradesh? Is everything because of the BJP? So Samajwadi Party government there absolves itself of all responsibility for the many lives that have been lost, 243 incidents. Who is polarizing? Why can you point fingers at the other party?
Mr. Narendra Modi
without holding yourself accountable.
Apologize for the Godhra riots even till now. He is not spoken.
Let's
on
talk
the
about
riot.
2013. Let's talk so about Samajwadi Party. Let's and talk about Uttar Pradesh. That's the point right now.
I think
Gaurav Bhatia, before
Mr.
you point
Akhilesh
fingers
Yadav,
at the BJP
Mr.
and blame the BJP or Amit Shah
Mr.
for Muzaffarnagar, who is accountable for 243 other incidents?
Who is trying to polarize votes? The Muzaffarnagar riot.
Why is Mulayam Singh fielding himself from Azamgarh?
On a public platform, said that.
Why is Mulayam Singh fielding himself from Azamgarh?
Gaurav, just explain that.
Does he have the courage to say the same?
What is the like? You were talking about the agenda behind Varanasi. So what is the agenda behind Azamgarh then? Why Azamgarh? What is the specific agenda behind the choice of Azamgarh?
If there is any party that can stop the BJP from spreading its communal venom, it's the Samajwadi Party.
If there is any leader, it is Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav
who can counter their communal venom.
But you've been saying there is no Modi wing.
Why is Mulayam Singh then not taking Narendra Modi on from Varanasi?
Your party has been saying there is no Modi wave. You've been saying there is no BJP wave. Then why this sudden rush?
I request both of you not to simultaneously ask two questions. Please.
Go ahead, Gaurav Bhatia.
I was only saying that if you pay attention, the four lists that BJP have released, I was going through them. There are 210 candidates that they have declared. Only five of them are from the Muslim community. And this has happened in the past also.
Who is trying to polarize again?
What we are talking about is a serious question of inclusiveness.
Nirmala Sitharaman, please respond to that.
If minorities means communalizing the election, then you can blame us for that. We are talking about upliftment for the minority community, and their own list shows.
No, but by profiling candidates along these lines, who is actually raking up the issues of, you know, polarity of votes and communalism? Nirmala Sitharaman, please respond to what Gaurav Bhatia is saying.
With due respects to Mr. Bhatia, he's been pouring his heart out. If he doesn't take that I'm being disrespectful of his view, it was a diatribe. First they complained saying, oh, he's a leader confined to Gujarat. He can't even come anywhere outside. Now he comes to Uttar Pradesh and says, right, I contest from a place here. Then they say, oh no, you saw the way he's polarizing. He goes there and says, let us be very clear. We want to address the aspirations of all the population. We are not talking about any one community. And then we hear Mr. Bhatia looking into the BJP's list and say, how many Muslims? I don't think he should be spending time
Why
on
not?
These sort of things.
Why shouldn't
After
I question that? Nirmala Sitaraman ji, this same thing happened in Gujarat. In out of the 180 seats, there was not even
respect,
a single person from the minority
finish?
Community.
If the attempt is to shut
yes,
me up, I'll
absolutely.
Keep quiet. But I think when I have not interrupted
no,
when
I was
he
just
spoke,
pointing out
a
the
complete
Gujarat
diatribe. I have not even stopped.
Ms. Sitaraman, please make your point.
I'll appreciate if you allow me to finish without interruption and the anchors would please kindly enable the process.
Go ahead, please. Go ahead, Ms.
Sitaraman.
Please make your point quickly. Yeah.
See, the point is when you're talking about development for all, there's more time spent on looking into the BJP's list as to how many communities are represented and other things. We'll certainly do that after the exercise of distribution of ticket is over. But the moment is, at this moment, I'd like to ask, if after Akhilesh Yadav took over Uttar Pradesh, let us, even in the assembly, the number of riots which have been accounted for touches somewhere near 200. And there is this audacity of thought where they are saying, oh, Mr. Modi has not apologized for Godhra 2002. Courts are going through, everybody has spoken about it. And now, when the tenure of Akhilesh Yadav continues, with 200 riots, communal small and big tension riots, having taken place, look at your own credibility and look at your performance.
Okay, we're talking about Azamgarh. Now, Sabha Naqvi,
no,
we can come to you.
To
this
Mr.
choice
Mr.
of Azamgarh. Now, despite what the Samajwadi Party is saying here tonight, Sabha, despite what the SP is saying here tonight, is Azamgarh and the choice of Azamgarh not an attempt at polarizing votes? I mean, the Azamgarh has been a nerve center of minority politics even in the past. Everyone remembers Mulayam Singh asking for a judicial probe into the Bhatla House encounters where the terrorists that had been killed were in fact from Azamgarh. I mean, it's been a hotbed of minority politics, and by fielding the party supremo from there, is it not an attempt from the Samajwadi Party to polarize votes?
First of all, just let me give you one geography. It is very important for you to understand that Azamgarh is less than 100 kilometers from Varanasi.
Yes.
It is less than 100 kilometers from Varanasi. I also want to tell you the most important politician of the Azamgarh has been a gentleman who is adorned with lots of charges against him called Ramakant Yadav, who has won repeatedly on SP and is now with the BJP. He is a don of that area. It is clearly there is a politics going on where Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav has landed up in Azamgarh, which is something which I heard about from BJP sources that this is likely to happen. It's a very interesting tango that
are you hinting at a tacit understanding somewhere, Sabha?
Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav is facing a credibility. I'm not saying they have an understanding. I'm saying they expect to play a communal tango.
Yes.
Even though Mr. Modi will carry on talking about development, but I just traveled in UP. At the ground level, the cadre, there is a lot of Sangh Parivar cadre over there. I traveled to Gonda, Basti, Faizabad, Barabanki. I have done the journey between Varanasi and Azamgarh on every election, and I will do it now. It is a very interesting stretch of Uttar Pradesh. Varanasi has obviously been chosen because of the symbolic importance and the fact that it cradles Bihar, Uttar Pradesh. There's even some conjunction with Madhya Pradesh. It is the Kashi Vishwanath issue. Even though Mr. Modi himself will carry on saying, I'm only for development, it is to give people a sense of Hinduness.
Right.
Similarly,
absolutely.
Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav is facing a huge credibility crisis. So he has gone to Azamgarh, which has been dominated by a criminal who has been...
Well, he's batted for all three parties. He's batted for three parties.
And now has
Samajwadi Party,
ticket.
BSP, and
you
also
know?
The BJP, Sabha Naqvi, as you're talking about Ramakant Yadav. But let's go across to Sudhindra Bhadauria.
Yeah.
Is the BSP having
Ramakant
a quiet
Yadav.
Laugh about it? Are you looking to score off the fight between the BJP and the Samajwadi Party? Or have you,
or are you
already opted out of the race?
Or are you worried, yes, that the anti-Modi vote is going to be split?
I'm getting a chance after a long time, so let me just briefly say this. that both Mulayam Singh and Modi are different sides of the same coin. And let me tell you that if Mr. Modi is responsible for the Gujarat riots and the death of hundreds of people over there, similarly, Mulayam Singh Yadav is also responsible, along with his son, for the over 100 riots, along with the most heinous and the most brutal carnage that took place in Indian history recently in Muzaffarnagar, where over a lakh people were rendered homeless. Both are now trying to, the city of Azamgarh and Banaras are adjacent to each other, fighting over there and trying to spread communal hatred in the rest of the state and across the North India is the design of these two people. Let me also say this, the city of Banaras is a city of Mahatma Buddha, where he first gave his preachings, and also the city of Sant Kabir Das, where he united both the Hindus and Muslims.
So what you're saying, Mr. Bhadauria, you're essentially saying what Sabha Naqvi said, where the Samajwadi Party and the BJP are engaged in this communal tango as far as Azamgarh and Varanasi are concerned. If we can go across to CR Keshavan now, who stands to lose? If the votes in eastern Uttar Pradesh get completely polarized, who stands to lose the most? It's the Congress.
And is the Congress anywhere in the fray? Azamgarh you would give up because of reciprocatory courtesy, if I may say so. And what about Varanasi? You've not announced a candidate there too. So are you already out of the race in eastern Uttar Pradesh?
I think that's wishful thinking on your part. Let me start by saying this on two counts. One about why Narendra Modi ji is contesting Varanasi and then coming back to Mulayam ji. See, everybody is touting. I saw on your news clip when the program started, there is a Narendra Modi ji wave in the country. And you know, he's such a symbol of unity. If there is a Narendra Modi ji wave in the country, why doesn't he contest from Muzaffarnagar Lok Sabha? If he's such a man of unity.
So if there is no wave, why is Mulayam Singh contesting from Azamgarh?
Leave alone.
Why is Congress hesitating to field a candidate?
If you let me complete.
If you let me complete, I can complete. Go ahead.
Second point is, and we still hear that he's, you know, there are speculation that he may still contest from Gujarat. So that's fine. Having said that, my perplexing point is the BJP chief, who's a sitting MP from Ghaziabad, is running for cover. And he shifted his constituency. Let's leave aside that. Coming back to Mulayam ji, like you said, there is a reciprocatory gesture there. But I think one important point you're forgetting is the backlash for both the BJP and the SP in terms of the Muzaffarnagar riots. And that, I think that is why they're going as far as away possible to, you know, eastern UP. I think nobody will forget the way, you know, as you mentioned, you know, Mr. Vishnu, you know,
not questioning anybody's political acumen here, Mr. Keshavan. You would understand that the eastern UP belt is very critical for all the parties. Because the wave happens and when you want to garner maximum seats, you want to dominate that Purvanchal belt and the effect will trickle into...
There is no wave here. Mulayam ji has always contested from Mainpuri, and I think, you know, the way the Safai Mahotsav happened in the Etawah district...
If there was no wave, why is Mulayam Singh coming to Azamgarh?
Better to have another
information. Why would he not continue to just contest from Mainpuri? It's been made very clear today by the Samajwadi Party because that they're coming out there to Azamgarh because
that
they too. Want
he's
to stonewall Narendra Modi.
Please understand that there are two seats he's contesting. He's not left Mainpuri and come to, you know, Azamgarh.
Why has he done that?
And his communal politics is Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav. And there is nothing new. It is the Samajwadi Party that has been fighting the communal politics of BJP. I was listening to Mrs. Sita Raman. I would just like to say, I don't know why she has such a strong objection if I have revealed the true figures from the list. Every party is entitled to scrutinize other parties' list.
And but why are you deciding that only a certain
Gujarat,
only people from certain factions will work for the development?
Listen,
if you are a political leader, will you not work for the development of the society on the whole? Who is trying to then polarize? Who is trying to then polarize? You elect a person expecting that person to rule, govern and work for that particular constituency. So how can you break them into caste, creed and religion? Why is the Samajwadi Party hell-bent on doing that?
Please, I'll tell you, the government has been working for upliftment of all communities and caste and religion It's not only about one community. But then when Gujarat elections came,
you are making it about one community.
Out of the 180 seats, not even a single person was minority. When it was UP assembly
elections, why are you bothered about what's happening in Gujarat? Why can't you set matters right in Uttar Pradesh first and answer the questions? 200 plus riots in 2 years' time. What is the answer that the Uttar Pradesh government has to give? What is the answer Samajwadi Party has to give? All that is brushed under the carpet.
I will answer your question.
Why should somebody go ahead and vote for Mulayam Singh and not
given?
Why should somebody go ahead and vote for Samajwadi Party for more riots, is it? I ask you the simple question.
Yeah, I'll answer your question.
Can I?
Yes. In the parliament, the minister, home minister, answered that in Gujarat, in 2012, there have been 60 riots, and in 2030, there have been 61.
243 in Uttar Pradesh. With you having 224 seats and ruling government, nobody asking questions, what have you done?
The population of Gujarat is, listen to me, can you allow me, the population of Gujarat is not even one third of the state.
Don't give us population figures. I am asking you governance figures. I am asking you governance ability. Sabha Naqvi, you have a point to make.
Yes, let's go across to Sabha now because that, you know, when this is not the point we're discussing here tonight, Mr. Bhatia. Sabha, you wanted to come in. Sabha?
I just, if I can get a word in, I just want to say that it's, no, but
Gaurav Bhatia, I'll come back to you.
You know,
sir,
everybody has been, it's so pathetic that parties which want to, their leader to be a PM should carry on having comparative lists of riots. That's not the point right now.
Yeah.
Be very aware, Azamgarh is a seat dominated by a lot of Yadavs. Mulayam Singh Yadav is going to break, trying to break that. But no, there is another point here about the kind of...
Gaurav Bhatia, please let Sabha Naqvi complete her point. Please let her make her point.
The SP has failed. No, there is a point. Look, the party that nobody is adequately... You have somebody from the Bahujan Samaj Party. The Azamgarh seat has been won twice by the Bahujan Samaj Party by combining the Dalit vote, which nobody talks about here. I think it adds up to about... there is a 25% scheduled caste vote if it combines with the Muslim vote. Why has Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav gone running to Azamgarh? Because the Don of Azamgarh, who he has given a ticket to in the past, the Yadav Don, is standing from there, from the BJP. So he wants to make sure that the Yadav vote is split. It is really sort of a terrible tango. They are all, you know, they put Muslims on the line with the pathetic way they chase that vote when they are themselves have provided such a shocking misgovernance in that state. And they raise secularism. You know, so Mr. Gaurav Bhatia, it is so pathetic to see you produce lists.
Yes, Mr. Bhatia.
Riots here and riots there. Look at your own record. You know?
Yes, Mr. Bhatia. Gaurav Bhatia, I'll come to you in a bit. Just wait on a bit. Sudhindra Bhatia, go ahead, please.
Who came forward? There's a history behind
that. He took responsibility for that.
In 1992, they raised the slogan that Babri Hui Hamari Hai. Mathura Kashi ki bari hai. So that is why they have come to Kashi, Banaras, because it is from here they want to continue their own agenda of hatred, of communal hatred, and also
1, 2, 3, 4, all four on the screen are talking about polarizing votes. Who's talking about development? Who's talking about good governance?
Making a political
that proves
point,
the point of the debate, isn't it, Ms. Sitaraman?
People of UP understand.
See, they may make any amount of, or any number of attempts. We are repeatedly raising questions of meeting aspirations of the young, trying to reach out to people, and how many ever times Mr. Bhatia would quote that statistics of 61 or 62 riots. Last 10 years in Gujarat, you've seen complete peace, as opposed to the 2 years of Sri Akhilesh Yadav's government in Uttar Pradesh, with ultimately five. There we go, interruption. Hold on. In the last two years, you have seen a precipitation of violence, communal violence, resulting in lakhs of people sitting outside of their houses in the cold winter.
And therefore, to be blamed for
no
that?
Attempt your to shift the debate MLA to Gujarat
that you were
will help.
Mr. Sangeet Soam, Mr. Suresh Rana.
I have
These MLAs belong to your party, Mr. Sitaraman.
I will answer, Mr. Bhatia.
And you are felicitating them.
Who was the man who was in governance? Who was the man who was supposed to be?
I think it is a very important question. Why don't you answer that question?
Which government was in power in Uttar Pradesh? Which government should have stepped in to stop it?
Yes.
Which government should be answerable for the death of more than 33 people in the relief camps?
Can I?
Post the riots, what happened in the relief camps?
Would you just hold on for a minute, Mr. Bhatia? Mr. Bhatia, your favorite three questions, which is always asked in every program about BJP, I will keep answering them any number of times.
And they have never been answered also.
You have only
that is
given
so
us
strange. Yes.
You that is the problem, no? You don't allow us to answer. You go on
all
interrupting
right.
For fear that I will ask you a question on Azam Khan. You're scared that I'll ask you a question.
Gaurav Bhatia,
doesn't hold good at all.
We're going to go into a very short break right now. We continue this discussion on the other side. Gaurav Bhatia, we'll get your response first on the other side of this short break.